Homeopathy, alternative medicine beloved by the royal family and by millions around the world, but does it actually work? Hi guys, Julia here for DNews. Homeopathy, a very contentious form of alternative medicine practiced by millions all over the world. The National Health Service in the UK spends about £4 million a year on these kind of treatments, and some estimates place that number as high as £11 million, so it's more than just a fringe movement. In fact, even the royal family seems to be fans. The Queen's physician, Peter Fisher, recently called for more people to use it. He says that it's safe, popular with patients, improves clinical outcomes without increasing costs, and reduces the use of potentially hazardous drugs, including antimicrobials. Although in the US, the National Institute of Health says that there is little evidence to support homeopathy as an effective treatment for any specific condition. So what is it? Homeopathy isn't a new idea. It was introduced by the German physician Samuel Hahnemann over 200 years ago. Homeopathy's premise is based on a few interesting ideas. According to the National Center for Homeopathy, the first idea is that like cures like. And that's what homeopathy means in Greek, same suffering. Or that something that produces symptoms in a healthy person makes a sick person healthy. So, like caffeine, a molecule that keeps people awake, might be used to treat people with insomnia, but only if caffeine is diluted to very small amounts. And that's the second premise. The more dilute the remedy is, the more potent it is. And thirdly, that the illness is specific to the person. Homeopaths take into account a holistic view of a person. So how is the medicine made? Well, let's go back to that caffeine example. A bit of caffeine goes through the process of potentization, which involves dilution and succussion, which is vigorous shaking. So all the toxic effects of the extract or compound are removed. And when I say dilution, I mean a lot of dilution. Something might be diluted 1 in 130 times in a solution of water or sugar. Medicine doses are based on the centesimal or C scale. A 2C dilution requires a substance to be diluted to 1 part in 100, and then some of that mixture being diluted again to 1 part in 100. So basically you wind up with 1 part of the original substance in 10,000 parts of the solution. And so on and so forth, this process can be repeated. Basically, the plant or animal extract is so diluted that there's almost no molecules of it left. And according to homeopathic theory, the more diluted it is, the more potency it has. Homeopaths believe that water retains the memory of that extract. The idea is that after each dilution, the extract in water, sugar, or whatever the solution is, goes through succussion, which activates the vital energy of the extract. Okay, so that's basically the whole process in a nutshell, but what does the science say about it? Well, one study published in the journal Rheumatology found that homeopathy helped arthritis patients over the course of 6 months when added alongside conventional medicine. But it was because of its unique consultation process. Basically, homeopathy treats the patient, not just the symptom. So it's really the one-on-one patient-focused appointments that helped, not the homeopathic medicine. And the National Health and Medical Research Council of Australia found no evidence that homeopathy is effective. In a report published last year, the NHMRC looked at 57 systematic reviews of the treatment. They found that there were no health conditions for which homeopathy was effective, and that no good large-scale studies found that homeopathy was better than a placebo. And Edzard Ernst, emeritus professor at the University of Exeter, wrote in an opposing letter to the Queen's physician that homeopathy is implausible and that it flies in the face of science. So it looks like science isn't on the side of homeopathy. But you know what science does support? Meditation.
If you need to psych yourself up to do well on a test or a job interview, maybe you should meditate. And when you need to calm down after, a different kind of meditation can bring you back down again.
So what do you all think? Is homeopathy hocus pocus or just misunderstood? Leave your thoughts down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews. We've got new episodes every day of the week.